Welcome back to another episode of That 911 Guy. Today's instalment is all about this, the 964 Turbo 3.6 with a difference. You see, we're going to be delving back into the Porsche archives to look at chiefly the work of the legendary exclusive department, which gave us this, the alternative silhouette of the 964 Turbo Flatnose. Now, where do we start? This particular car, one of 76 produced for worldwide markets, one of just 12 right-hand drive, but we're gonna come to all of that shortly. First of all, as ever, it's good to get a bit of historical context as to why the 911's iconic silhouette was altered for the 964 Turbo, but also the 930 SE beforehand as well. The flat nose or Flachbau 911's origins are in racing. It all stems from the legendary mind of Mr. Norbert Singer, who designed the flat nose 935 that we now know as Moby Dick. It was essentially Singer's ingenious interpretations of the FIA rulebook for the 1978 motor racing season, which gave us the Moby Dick. Now, it wasn't so much about what the rulebook said, more about what it didn't. The paper said that your GT race car must retain the original body, doors, and roofline. It didn't say anything about changing the shape of the fenders. The Moby Dick might be one of the most iconic Porsche race cars of all time, but it definitely was not one of the most successful. For the 1978 motor racing season, it only raced a handful of times with one solitary victory, which was here in the UK at Silverstone. So that pretty much outlines the origins of the Flachbau 911 in racing. However, how on earth did we get to the stage where the flat-nose 911 grace the public roads? That all came down to Porsche Exclusive, the Sonderwunsch department. And that all came about, may I add, thanks to one of the most divisive items of specification ever to grace the 911, the rear wiper. It was actually in the time of the 911's predecessor in the 356, where a customer approached Porsche and asked for a rear wiper on the back of his 356. It wasn't something that Porsche ordinarily did at the time. However, the request or wish, the special wish, was able to be fulfilled. Hey presto, Porsche's special wishes department was formed. Fast forward to the start of the 1980s, and it was Mansour OJ, I might be butchering the name, apologies if so, CEO of TAG at the time, big, big Porsche enthusiast. He, as I alluded to earlier on, wanted a 935 flat nose for the road. Porsche's special wishes department duly created that. I think it was cherry red. It might not be the proper name of that paint color, but it had the flat nose shape of the 911 race cars with pop-up headlights and a 935 style wing. That, plus the fact that Porsche began to get further requests for flat nose 911s, plus the fact that third party coach builders were also building flat nose 911s for customers, Porsche decided to do something drastic. Special wishes as a kind of ad hoc program was scrapped in favor of a brand new department called Porsche Exclusive. Porsche Exclusive was born, therefore, out of the divisive rear wiper, which I would like to argue is a very practical piece of specification on the 911. Okay, that is your pretty comprehensive fill of historical context on this car. So we might as well talk about the subject of today's video. It's a very, very rare, special beast indeed. It is, of course, the 964 Turbo S Flatnose. Produced in 1994, that, by the way, was the last year of 964 model production, wasn't it? Courtesy of Porsche Exclusive, as we know, just 76 of these were built for worldwide markets, only 12 of them as right hookers as here. As you can see, its front profile is completely different from those upright gun barrels of the 964. It's actually in profile, this front fender here, not too dissimilar to the 993 that of course replaced the 964 at the end of this model year. The headlights are the most standout thing here, of course, aren't they? Porsche aficionados might recognize these, of course, from the 968. Where the 964 flat nose differs to the 930 flat nose, or 930S for American enthusiasts, is of course, on the 930, the headlights are hidden. They then pop up to reveal themselves, if you like. These are receded into the body and then obviously pop out, much the same as the 968 does. So there's nothing too dissimilar there. Of course, from there, Porsche Exclusive has breathed its magic on the car, and there are a lot of changes compared to even the 3.6 964 Turbo itself. These air intakes, RS style, of course, you might recognize them from the 3.6 and 3.8 litre 964 RS, feeding air to the front brakes, of course. There's a different front splitter there. If we come backwards to the car, there's plenty more magic to reveal themselves. Of course, starting with the legendary split rim Speedline wheels. They did come on the 964 Turbo 3.6, of course, along with the red brakes, but they're really cool nevertheless. Now, this is the first time a Porsche 911 has had its rear arches punctured. Of course, its exact style and form you might see is taken directly from the 959 of the late 1980s. It wasn't until the 996 generation that the side air intakes on the turbo started feeding air to the intercoolers. They call brakes for now. At the rear of the car, it's the iconic, isn't it? T-tray rear wing. Differs slightly in profile to the 930 beforehand, namely because in 964 form, it doesn't have the rubber lip going around the edge to protect pedestrians, by the way. It's a special engine in this, given away by the fact that we've not got one exit for the exhaust, but actually one on either side. And that is because not only is this Flatnose factory option X84, which is Flatnose, it's also X88, which for the 964 generation signified power kit. The power kit boosted horsepower from the 360 horsepower of the 964 Turbo 3.6 up to 385 horsepower, so it was an extra 25 horsepower in there. So I hope the picture is beginning to be painted. It's a really, really special car, isn't it? Not only is it flat nose optioned, it has the power kit. It's a proper collector's car. It only has 1,000 kilometers on the clock as well. With its extremely low mileage being detrimental to its high value, and out of respect to the new owner who agreed to let me film the car before even he'd taken collection, today was not a drive video. But even firing it up and maneuvering between shots, it made for a different 964 Turbo experience without those usual gun barrel front fenders providing any point of reference. An acquired taste, yes, but the Flachbau is a big part of Porsche history. Okay then, that is the story of the 911 Flatnose, with particular reference to this pretty legendary car, isn't it? The 964 Turbo S Flatnose with the power kit. The Flatnose silhouette is quite divisive, isn't it, in Porsche circles. I, however, absolutely love the look. It's a perfect homage to the late 1970s and early 1980s of Porsche 911 racing. Such a key and successful part of the 911's racing lineage, isn't it? More than anything though, this is a genuine road-going homage to the brilliant mind of Mr. Norbert Singer.